Ruby on Rails 7 is out. Code along on a guided journey through the Rails 7 Getting Started Guide and beyond with test-driven development. There has never been a better time to learn Ruby on Rails. Hit the ground running with the newest version. Go to statelesscode.com/gettingstartedwithrails7 to level up. Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 8 in our series, Enough Inkscape to be Dangerous. And in this episode, I will be trying to design the logo for my Why Stateless Code series. So the inspiration for this is going to be the golden circle from Simon Sinek's Start With Why. So I will start with the Stateless logo transparent. And we'll save that as pause and create a new folder. So we'll go back to my new Why Stateless Code directory and we'll call this Why Stateless Code. All right, so now in terms of layers, I've got the logo layer. I will add, I think it's going to wind up being a layer above. Add that. Question is whether I want to have it be kind of a large portion of a semicircle or the whole set of circles here. So looking here, we've got, I can do the three circles or I could kind of do a cross section of them. I'll kind of play around with that and see how it goes, but lock the logo layer and we'll use the ellipse tool. I should pause and take a look at it in the documentation. It would help if I go to the correct layer and attempt to make my ellipse. Those are not the colors I want, but we'll just take a look at this for a moment. All right, so here is Inkscape's own documentation about ellipses and segments and arcs. So I think arcs are what I'm going to want here. We go here, stroke. I think I want 143 here. And then, so I want a thicker line, but no fill, I think is where I'm going to. I guess at least get the basic shape here. Let me zoom out a bit. This is about where I want this line. No fill. Alright, let's get the golden circle circular here. Okay. And then let me recenter. Then I just need to thicken this line. That's giving me the thickness I want. So I think I'm going to move the stateless logo up here to give more room for the circle segments. Let's do that. Switch back to my layer, lock the golden circle, unlock the logo. We're going to move you up. Recenter. Now that will affect the positioning of our circle. So we're going to want to move the circle upwards. going to be, move this. That was too far. I think that works, and then I want to get the other two circles concentric on this. Create a new layer for each of these. All right, so I'm going to want to do the same thing here. So in this case, I'm going to want a larger radius than what I had before. This is going to be our, I'm on the what layer. Let's move it to so now we're in the how layer. Come on. Oh, that. Okay, let's get back to the points on this. So go with 30. That is too large. Looks about right. We just need to position it now. Center vertically, and then we're going to move down. Those are not concentric. I think I need a slightly larger radius. All get back to then the third one, I barely even need a hint of it, I don't think, but this will do it. So lock, why and how, we'll do what. New ellipse. Try 31. I think that kind of gives me what I want. Sure, we're centered vertically. Now I need some text. Let me see what I've got so far. All right, so I'm gonna now click on the text tool. Actually, we're gonna get a, I'm gonna make the text its own layer. Lock everything else. Here, this is going to be the same color as my other layer, so let me pause and get the HSL on that. So it's 143, 45, 53. Get back to our text layer, relock. Unlock. We've got our text here, and most of the time Comic Sans is not what you want, but Let's see if there are other. I'll try it and see if it gives me. That's actually what I want, so. Size is too large here. That gives me about the right size. So that's 12 point bold Comic Sans. Let's get it. Vertically centered, and then horizontally, we need the Y down a couple. Oops. We will now put this on the path. Now we'll do the same thing with our how. Of course. Sans bold, size 12. Gets me where I want it, and text on path. Finally, our what? Deal. All keeps this on the paper. And now the next thing I want is kind of an arrow, kind of line with arrow going from the Y out past the what. So we'll try that. That should be its own layer. No, hold on. Back to the text layer. I did not put what on the path. Now we're on the path. Lock text, move to arrow. And for the arrow, I'm going to see if there's something on Wikimedia Commons that's CC0 that I can just use here without an import, without having to make my own. So that is going to be my first path. I'll pause and see if I find something that's useful. All right, so even though this isn't pointing the way that I want it to, I think this gives me what I'm going to go for. So this is by Marion Sigler in let me just validate that it's CC0. It is public domain, so I can use it. I will download the linked file. Then I'll import it. All right, so I've got it at 323, which kind of offsets the 180 degrees off of what I had before. And I think this will work for my overall Y stateless code. And then I'm going to save. So I've got this saved. It should be called transparent. Transparent uncropped, and then we'll do a save as again. And crop it to the page. I'm going to do a little bit of testing, so I'm going to go in to my pictures directory here. And let's see what happens when I open this with. Sure, we'll do Chrome. Alright, so it doesn't look like I need to do any cropping. Anything that goes outside of the page does not get included in there. I think I'm going to move up a little bit so that the circle for the what gets included. I think it would look better with that now that I see it. Question is, how can I do that without completely messing up everything? If I can do something with the page settings. If I go 150 by 150. Makes just a larger portion of it. Let me see. I'm going to save that. I might like this. So let's go back, and this is our cropped version. Open with Chrome. Yeah, and once I have a fill there, I think it's going to work a bit better. So I think I'll stop there and pick up on the next episode doing some variations on this and getting a fill for it and everything. Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels, follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.